Just quickly, a little bit about myself. My name is Janvi, and I come from an organization called Anandi, which stands for Area Networking and Development Initiatives. We've been working in Gujarat with rural women, with some of the most marginalized communities, for the past 19 years. We're actually in the 20th year right now. Our primary experience is with women and building women's leadership. So we work with about some 10,000 odd women on different issues ranging from food security, maternal health, livelihoods, governance, and so on. So that's where, when I was asked by Anita to do my synthesis, so I think it's also important to understand the position from which I'm going to be speaking. Can we have a first?
I'm here.
Okay. I was wondering where she disappeared. Okay. So I thought that, you know, it's difficult, and I personally do believe that each of us have to make meaning of the world from the position that we are in. So I desist from saying that this is a synthesis that I have, but what I'd like to do is to, say, put out some pegs which will help to cluster the thoughts which have been coming around in different ways from participants and from the panelists. So I thought some of the issues that we need to keep in mind. Nobody has perhaps used the word patriarchy very explicitly, but I think when we talk about feminism, it is understood. But I think it's important to foreground and to keep understanding that there is a project of patriarchy which is at play at all times, and we need to understand it whenever we are taking in new information, listening to stories, and especially in a place of this kind. I think there was a lot of talk about marginalized and vulnerable communities in the talk that we had about access. And however, I kept feeling that it was kind of assumed that because we're talking about internet, we do not have to, somebody else will kind of, you know, take care of how we can reach the most marginalized and the most vulnerable. I think that is a question that we perhaps need to answer, that in my position, in wherever I am, what am I doing about this category? And therefore, I mean, it was referred to in senses of access, issues of time from both sides. And local languages is spoken, so I'm not going to talk about it. I think the question is, what is the larger public good? And the question of what is good for the larger public. That question that we need to keep asking when we, I think some of the people mentioned it. See, on the other hand, I think what I've tried to do is to also say that some of the positives that came up, that yes, women, children, vulnerable communities have shown a great potential and an ability to relate to it. It's not that because they are illiterate or because they are in their village, they're not amenable to, you know, dealing with data and with technology. So I think those stories are extremely the positive, and, you know, give a way forward. And what have they? What has been their role in? I think the key thing is in creating data and in using it to influence data. It's not so much about ki maine computer seekh liya hai, but it's also about ki maine us computer ka use kiske liye kiya, usme kya data maine dala, usme se jo data nikla usse maine kya kiya. Mujhe lagta hai ki in sawalon ke saath jujhna aur ye zyada mahatvapurna hai, kyunki kai baar programs, projects sirf output ke upar jab reh jate hain to hum ye report kar dete hain ki itna seekh liya, mapping seekh liya, you know, computer seekh liya, but is it a part of creation and is it part of to use decision making? So I think that's very important that we need to think about. I think this whole thing about virtual space and physical space, the story that even Roshni mentioned, that ultimately, you know, people landed up to see this guy. And on the other hand, we are talking about women's groups, Dalit groups, who believe that unless and until you talk about Sangathan, unless and until you have women, people come together out in public, show solidarity, take action in public space, you cannot change power structures, you cannot be talking about transformation, because there is something about being physically out there. Next one, please. And then a couple of things which lead to complications. I think the first sets of slides was very standard. I think I'm not saying something new. But I think this, the, some of the speakers really brought in the whole issue of intersectionality. And the key question to ask is, what is ICTs doing to the women's agency? We've already known that there are issues about how women are allowed to do certain things, not allowed to do certain things. And within that, whether in the virtual world, are we replicating what is there in the physical world when it comes to gender inequalities? I think these are the questions that really should be addressed. Some of them were addressed, but we all need to make our own meanings out of it. Now you have in all of this, I think the questions that we have is, what all should women worry about? You know, should women be worrying about the physical safety and security in internet and in digital space? Or should be worried about big data? Or we say that big data is, you know, too difficult for us to handle and, you know, let somebody else deal with it. I'll talk about the safety and security issues and, you know, privacy issues. Or do we also say that women also need to be talking about governance, in the technology-related governance? So I think it's also a question of, you know, do you take the attitude that, oh, women are already dealing with so many things, why should they be dealing with everything else? But let's at least make sure that it's a safe space. Or do we also say that you have to simultaneously talk about all of these issues if you want to further the women's agency, the feminist agenda, transformation, a world where women and men are equal, all sexual identities are equal? Is that the kind of space that we are talking about? And therefore, we need to engage with all of this simultaneously. And how is it possible? And, you know, can new technologies help us there, or are they hindering us? I think that's the question. So there are new spaces of activism that have been opened up. But I think being rooted in the real world of poverty, we saw stories of that, homelessness, hunger, maternal death. And all of this, how are we seeing it from the eyes of women who get affected? Because very often, and I think that's something that our work with as Anandi, we have found that very often in the feminist debates, a lot of discussion gets much more time about the physical and the bodily integrity and about identities. But women, a large number of women, are also dealing with issues of homelessness, poverty, hunger, you know, death of their own children, their own sisters, you know, mothers dying. And somehow this space is seen as something to do with the livelihood or, you know, poverty, and which is not being adequately engaged. And I think for us and our work shows that there is no escape from having on working on both of these together. So how do you define this? And to that extent, yes, when you have projects where you know, like Khabar Leheria or like KMVS's work, it is women who are shaping the content and the agenda and the framing of the analysis, and that's very critical. Finally, and going back to my first point of patriarchy, we cannot escape power structures. And within the whole thing, like, you know, you have the whole Nirbhaya rape case, which got a lot of attention. We had legislation, but, you know, the Badaun rape cases, it's just that, you know, now the information has kind of gotten so complicated that you feel that somebody else needs to take care of it. Humne ek level of activism kar liya, abhi now it is somebody else's, you know, question. So how do you, you know, do we say that we have done enough? And leave it at that level. How do you compare the violence that was faced by, you know, I forget the name of the lawyer, Sanjay Singh's story where he was murdered. And at the same time, we also spoke about the violence that women journalists are facing. And there is no escape from this kind of assault when you are challenging power. But are they equal? You know, is the violence being faced by Sagarika Ghosh equivalent to the fear that Sanjay Sinha's family, for instance, has about him continuing this work? You know, so I think these are some of the questions that we need to look at. Hacking is a problem of celebrities, and that became a big issue. But when media is being used to incite communal violence, is that an issue? Or, you know, whose issue is that? I think that kind of power structures and who's asking the questions to whom, that remains a critical question to answer. The challenges that women face as journalists, issues of, you know, I'm saying that a little more positive, things that women as journalists are able to influence, participation in Gram Sabhas. We saw government is saying, yes, we want to promote that, we want to do that. I just wanted to flag this question. It came up in the morning that sustainability is asked. It's all, last point. It is about why should, you know, poor people, or when we are trying to do alternatives, be asked the question of sustainable, when actually the elite and a lot of us middle class lead some of the most unsustainable lives. You know, so the question itself about who is asking about sustainability, and if, you know, philanthropists are putting in their money to further the cause of good. So as a trust, if you are taking grant funds, it is some philanthropists who feel that he's doing good by giving money to you. So doing work on grant money, is that unsustainable? Or is it one way of, you know, making sure that some rich guy who's feeling for the, or a woman, who's feeling for the poor, you're helping them to, you know, make sure that the money is being used. So why is this being questioned that we'll give you a grant, but you have to become sustainable in 5 years, 10 years, 20 years or whatever. But we know that, for instance, Network 18 ran into a debt of 14,000 crores. And nobody's asking them about their sustainability or actually justifying it in other ways. So I think these are some of the questions we need to peg our thoughts in terms of what the speakers have been saying, what the positions that we have. And we have to seek our own answers. I don't think there are clear answers for anyone out there.